Greetings, fellow captains. In this episode, we'll tell you how to set the graphics parameters to play World of Warships comfortably. Let's start with the basics. The key indicator of game performance is the number of frames per second, or FPS, that your hardware is able to output to the screen. The higher the FPS, the smoother the picture on the screen. And vice versa. Low FPS will make the picture interrupted and jerky, which in turn will make a player angry and irritated. Poor gaming comfort is just one part of the problem. Low FPS can cause you to miss shots during a battle, much to the joy of the enemy team. If the FPS on your PC drops below 30 from time to time, it's a good idea to adjust the graphics settings. The fastest and easiest way to increase the performance is to select one of the preset options, which changes almost all graphics parameters. Four options are available: low, medium, high, and very high. If the game starts to remind you of a slideshow, try setting the graphics quality to a lower level. Follow this link to learn more about the system requirements of World of Warships and corresponding graphics settings. Now that you have all the information on the subject, we could finish this episode right here. However, in real life, there might be quite unconventional hardware configurations inside your computers. For example, a poor graphics card might be accompanied by a powerful CPU. If you simply lower the global levels of graphics quality, you'll miss the opportunity to get the maximum performance out of your hardware. As different graphics parameters are handled by different components, we can relieve weaker parts of your system and use the powerful ones to maximize FPS by fine-tuning some settings. In general, the number of frames per second depends on the CPU, graphics card, and hard drive. Let's see how different settings load different components of your computer. We start with the settings that require the most resources. The setting Effects Preset is responsible for the complexity and level of detail of artillery fire, smoke, sea foam in the wake of ships and torpedoes, and other traces of players' activity. They all put a heavy load on the CPU and the graphics card. The item Effects Quality is related to the resolution of visual effects. If each artillery salvo or fire causes a drop in FPS, try decreasing this parameter and your graphics card will breathe a sigh of relief. Sea rendering quality is the weightier setting for the graphics card. Decreasing this parameter will strongly impair the picture quality, but the performance will significantly increase. Shadow quality is quite an important setting, which loads both the CPU and the graphics card. It may cause trouble for less powerful configurations when trying to process a bunch of ships gathered in one place, or when you look at trees, houses, and other complex objects. We only recommend increasing the level of texture filtering if you have a powerful graphics card. This parameter should be one of the first that you disable if you want to have a high FPS. Unchecking the Animate Small Objects checkbox will simplify the display of some game elements. For example, a full squadron will be visually replaced by a single aircraft. This setting has a direct impact on the CPU performance. The foliage quality parameter is responsible for the appearance of trees. We only recommend selecting the very high level if your graphics card is ready for a serious load. If not, turn off this parameter for better performance. The draw distance option is responsible for the distance at which game objects such as ships, islands, or buildings on the shore start to be displayed. The object LOD parameter cuts parts of the visible elements of these objects, depending on the selected quality level. Both settings load the graphics card. Decreasing the resolution will have the biggest impact on low-performance graphics cards. you can relieve the CPU a little by checking the reduced GUI refresh rate checkbox. This will decrease the refresh rate of the game interface by half. It may start to freeze visually, but FPS will be higher. The texture quality setting directly affects the loading speed of the game maps and port. If your computer is short on RAM, it can seriously impair the general performance. High settings require 4GB of RAM, 3GB for medium, and 2GB for low. If there is not enough RAM, this parameter is able to overload the graphics card as well. If your graphics card can boast 1024MB of RAM, you can select high quality. If it has only 512MB, it's best to use low quality. The rest of the graphics settings don't put a significant load on the hardware and will give a boost of 1 or 2 FPS, even on low performance graphic cards. Anti-aliasing. FXAA applies a special post effect on geometry edges. Reflections have little effect on performance, but if you have a weaker CPU, you can try decreasing their quality. Vertical synchronization and triple buffering have an insignificant impact on the game performance. Post-processing lowers FPS by 1 or 2 frames on the graphics card. But we don't recommend disabling this setting. Signal flags have a small influence on the CPU and graphics card performance. Disabling soft particles can make it easier for low-performance graphics cards. Finally, decreasing sound quality is recommended, only if you have a slow hard drive, because the game's soundtrack is read constantly once per second. Now you know how to get the maximum performance out of your computer and ensure comfortable gameplay. We wish you high FPS, Captains. Until next time.